Let me tell you something, chat. Jerma is one of the sweetest people. And I really hope he's okay. He's going through some shit with his health right now. And, I heard about it. I wish him the best. And I understand his, you know, his decision to take some time off. I hope it gets him feeling better because, you know, he deserves to feel better. Anyway, hi everyone. Welcome to the stream. Boy, today was one of those shitty days for me. I had, some of you know that I had a stomach thing yesterday. Was feeling like absolute garbage. Today I wake up and my head's killing me and I thought I had a fever. So that was fun. And then I, you know, go to get in my car to get some food and I had a flat tire and I had to wait for the dude to repair my flat tire out in 89 degree weather. And I'll tell you what though, I slept for a good chunk of the day and he fixed the flat tire. And now my fever, if I had one, is gone. And I feel a little better. You know, I slept and I feel at least human again. So that's good. How was the chicken last night? It was good. It was good. I did have soup today. I had chicken tortilla soup and it was much needed. I made sure I got some soup for dinner, you know what I mean? Anyway, I don't know why I'm telling you all this, but here's another thing I can tell you. There's a bonus full sauce upload on the way. Vinny, no Hilux tonight. Okay, now I know everyone's telling me about Hilux again. And listen. I will definitely stream Hilux too. There's no rush on it. It's apparently a little buggy, so I'm waiting a little further for Hilux to be fully patched. So maybe a week or two. Jerma said hi. Well, tell Jerma. You know what? I'm just gonna message the dude after I'm done streaming. But anyway, welcome back to the stream. This is a long period of discussion and chatting right now. But let's get into it. Do you plan on playing the Hades update? Eventually. I'm gonna just enjoy this game for now. We'll get there. Vinny, tell us about Yoda's hut. Okay. I will tell you about the secret of Yoda's hut. If you promise to donate to the charity stream in a month. Even $5. Can you do that? Okay. Alright, so I'll tell you the secret of Yoda's hut. Many of you already know the secret, but I'll tell you later. Okay, here we go. Let's get started. Thank you for the raid, Jerma. And if you're watching right now, I was talking earlier. I really hope you feel better, man. I'm always here if you need me. And, you know, just take as long as you need. Yeah, my dad had some similar issues, and he's been, doing treatment. And you know what? He's been doing a little bit better. A lot better, in fact. So, you know, I wish you luck with that. And, take care of yourself, man. And when you come back, Coin Game was updated. So, That's something to look forward to. Vinny has a father. I was birthed into existence by an unholy union of trash and ducks. And pastas. And shrooms. Shroom pasta. What's the shroom pasta name? There's a name for it, isn't there? Scampi. Carbonara? Sure, that works. That works. So last time I played this... You know, this is my first time playing this game, so I'm still uncovering the secrets. The mysteries of the Yoda Hut. And I'm trying to find out, I know there's some stuff in here I didn't do, but maybe here would be good? Probably need to learn how to fly. What was that game where it was like, where did you learn how to fly? Let's try... landing on this twin first. Cybermorph? What is that? What is that? Oh, right, that game. Yeah, that's the... yep. Also, with all the requests to play, like, Hades Update, you know, and fucking Hylix 2, and here I am playing this, which is a great, fucking, wonderful game, but also Barn Finders. Yes, Barn Finders, everybody. That's up after this. People are talking about Pokemon. I didn't watch it. I am very not into Pokemon at the moment. But I have a feeling that a lot of people are pretty pissed. Wasn't it the most disliked Nintendo video, even above Federation Force, which, by the way, wasn't a completely fucking garbage game. Lame, but yeah, Tencent MOBA with Pokemon. So that's fun. I see why people are pissed. It's more disappointing than bad, which is, Federation Force or this MOBA that we're about to get. Because Federation Force ended up being just a slap in the face to Metroid fans waiting for a real Metroid game. But it was playable, just boring. It's just a fucking, like, pointless release that didn't need to exist. But it was fine for what it was, I suppose. Whoa. I guess we're here now. I guess we're on this planet now, why not? Vinny, do you think Metroid Prime 4 is in development hell? Not quite development hell, but I think that studio needs a lot of nudging. Because they are in the middle of restructuring and probably had some really hard times for a while. I mean, Retro in particular is what I'm talking about, yeah. So I don't think it's quite gone, I just think it's gonna need a little bit of extra love, and it's probably gonna be out way after people want it to be out. The shuttle is currently resting at the comet. Huh. Sunless City. Well, this is the shortcut to this place, which we've been to already, and there's cactus in the way. Someone said, I just want Metroid 5. There's rumors of a 2D Metroid being in the works, too, but again, rumors. Rumors. The shortcut was a bit higher up. Alright, well, the truth is, I don't even really know what the fuck I'm doing here right now, so... I was just trying to see... Oh, great. Well, my ship is over there, so... Am I gonna be able to get back? You know what? This is for the best. There was a switch way back there at the gravity cannon. Okay. Well, that was the worst loop yet. We learned nothing. Nothing was accomplished. Seems about right. The worst one was where 10 seconds after launch you flew into the sun. Okay, that one was worse. Here's the inside the seed, Northern Glacier, White Hole Station. Quantum Moon, Rybex Camp, The Hanging City. Quantum Moon Locator. So let's see. Well, we have the informations. Quantum Moon might be a form of macroscopic quantum mechanics. The Quantum Moon travels to a total of 5 locations. There's still a couple places we haven't been. So, I don't know. I'm just gonna... Well, I say a couple places. I mean most places. Really. Giant's Deep we haven't been to. You haven't been to the center of Ash Twin. Well, that's at the end of the loop, no? The fuck is that? What is this? Something really strange orbiting Giant's Deep. It's a divine beast. It looks like debris. It also looks like I might have thrusted too far. What the fuck is that? What the fuck are you? What is that? What is that? Was that beans? Wait, is this a gas giant? I guess that's why they call it giant. I'm afraid. Oh god, this is my worst nightmare. You chat. The idea of a gas giant, and like I've said many times, falling through Jupiter is frightening to me for some reason. And yet, there seems to be a spot to land. It doesn't really... I mean, a gas giant doesn't necessarily... Vinny, no suit? Oh. Well, I can breathe. I learned that I can breathe. It's very habitable. Hospitable. Pascrapamparto. This is it. We finished building the final orbital probe cannon module and are ready to send into orbit around Giant's Deep for assembly. Our next step will be to send Private up to the orbital probe cannon to install the probe tracking system. To all my friends here at Construction Yard, my gratitude for your tireless work. I had given up hope, but I truly believe this cannon may actually succeed where many other attempts have not. Are you going gelatinous on us, love? I'm delighted by your words, but they're atypical for you. If I'm ever half as gooey as Mallow and Avens behave together, Daz, you may launch me from the orbital probe cannon. If I know my brothers, Avens and his spouse, will want to launch the probe with as much power as possible, I'm worried the cannon would break under the strain. I propose we give Avens and Mallow a slightly lower maximum power setting than the absolute maximum possible to create room for their enthusiasm. Okay. So this is, I guess, where they launched. And, I think I saw it in orbit, but it was broken. We gotta figure out a way up there at some point. Oh, right, gravity. This one died over here. Wow. Yeah, this game is... This game is kind of perfect for me. Were we launched? Am I in space? What the fuck? We got... Whoa! Now I'm scared. This is really terrifying. This is really terrifying. Okay. Underwater. Okay. Okay. Control module projection stone. I have bad news, Avens. Yarrow says there was a problem with the proposed power source, so the orbital probe cannon won't be asked to fire. I hope you're pulling my locomotive limb here, Cassava. I wish I were, friend, but no, they aren't certain they can fix the problem, so the orbital probe cannon is on indefinite hiatus. Tell Privet and Mallow they should return from the cannon. My spouse and I will remain at the construction yard for now. Mallow and I will join you, and Daz. Privet left to visit her brother. She fears Idea may feel responsible. It's Mario RPG, I guess. 6 minutes, 3 seconds ago, long-range probe successfully launched from orbital probe cannon. What, like... Oh, shit, like, at the beginning of the loop it's launched? Huh. What the fuck? Whoa, what the fuck? Yeah, I don't know if we're seeing it from when we first wake up at a loop. I don't know if we're looking at Giant's Deep. We might be. This is what it looks like on board the thing. But we can't get too far. Hang on a second. I guess that's just a vision of what it looks like over there. Gravity's real high on this planet. Another projection stone. I guess we probably want to bring that over. I don't like the storm seems to be raging. Even further. What's that under there? Chat, there's a strange thing under there. Oh, this is salmon. Oh, the poor fish. Conoy, Daz, and I were lifting orbital probe cannon components into orbit for assembly, and one somehow sank down beneath the current. Cassava convinced me not to try to recreate the phenomenon myself using other cannon parts, but were very curious to know what happened. How could something pass through the current? My gratitude for your interesting question. This is exciting. Spire constructed a model of Giant's Deep here at Brittle Hollow's Southern Observatory. Okay. It reveals how much, how an object might sink below the current. Conoy, I'm unable to grasp the answer by looking through the projection pool. If I visit the observatory, would you kindly explain? If you don't mind the trek beneath the surface to the South Pole, I'd be delighted to see you. The trailhead starts at Brittle Hollow's equator. Would you kindly? Conoy, you should have seen it. We thought it was impossible for any cannon components to sink even partially below the current. But ours sank straight through to the core.
Oh. The planet core.
There's weird, like, episode one lore being revealed about, like, Qui-Gon being the only Jedi to be able to destroy Palpatine or something. I don't know. I don't know. There's just, some book is being written and it's like, revising lore. Okay. So this is Brittle Hollow, I think. Maybe it's the observatory. Yeah, it's definitely Brittle Hollow. Okay. Vin, deep water is my biggest fear. Get off this planet. Yeah, it's one of mine too. I just want to know how we keep getting launched into space. But Master Yoda, I'm not afraid.
You will be. You will be.
I can't get down there even if I try. Yeah, I can't find out what those glowing orange jellyfish things are. I do have an idea, though. Someone said I had a feeling you'd end up making a lot of Star Wars references. Well, I'm listening to the Art of the Score podcast. I just finished the Empire Strikes Back one, and now I'm listening to the original A New Hope one. And I just watched Empire, the despecialized edition, last night, as some of you know. And it was... It's just so good. It's so good. And without the special edition stuff, even though Empire wasn't touched as much, Harmy's despecialized edition. It's just so fucking good. I can't get down there even in my ship. How does Lord of the Rings stack up to Star Wars for you? I think it's a better trilogy. And I grew up wearing out those VHS tapes. I love the original trilogy of Star Wars very much. But I think, you know, I got into Lord of the Rings later on, and I dearly love it. And I think it's just more solid overall. It doesn't have the weak points. And considering Jackson, you know, planned it from the start, which, you know, J.J. Abramson's could have learned a little bit from that. So too Disney. Found a secret thing. But even Lucas had some stuff planned for the original trilogy, but not all of it. And it changed a lot along the way, right? So... So even though the original trilogy is pretty cohesive, you could still get a feeling that stuff was also kind of made up in between movies and rewritten and revised and, yeah. But I think, as an adaptation of the books, like, there's gonna be stuff missing. I know Lord of the Rings fans who don't like the movies because it's too different, and they made, like, Gimli a comedic character. But it really, as an adaptation, fucking works really well as a trilogy. You're right, like Christopher Tolkien, right? He did not care for the movies. There's no Tom Bombadil. You know, there's a lot of stuff. Old Man Willow was not really there. A lot of good stuff was missing. But it's a huge series of books. And I love that trilogy. I think they did a great job with it. Scouring of the Shire would have been nice. Be welcomed in this place. This tower shares all who ask the knowledge needed. Shares with all who ask the knowledge needed to make his or her first quantum journey. Oh, this is an important place to be.
Hey, hum, merry bum, Mr. Brow Willow. Beep, bop, bop, beep. Beat up, bop, bop.
Enter this place without friends, however. These are lessons you learn for yourself. Also, Lando is not all that, like, they don't give him a ton of lines in Empire, but yet it's so perfectly acted and scripted by Billy D and by, you know, Kasdan and Kirshner, that when you get to Lando, and, like, when you finish watching the movie, you're like, oh, Lando's great. Like, he's not in the movie a whole lot. They don't give him a ton of lines, but he's fantastic. Seek the Wandering Arch. Huh? The message thing is moving. I thought I was crazy, but you're right. It is. Oh, God. So is the arch. Oh. It changed. Okay. Unidentified signal nearby. Whoa, whoa, whoa. It's like 2001 monolith. Island shard. Quantum fluctuations. Yeah, I dropped a bunch of frames, chat. 1200. I'll just leave this paused until the stream works again. If I'm God damn it. If I'm live still, has anyone else been having this problem with other streams? Just me. All right. Well, then that's my problem. Germa was fine for 11 hours. Fucking hell. Okay, so yeah, this has been happening almost every night then. I don't know what to do. Oh my God. Well, in quantum mechanics, there are particles that, you know, depending on whether or not you're observing them, behave differently. So this seems to be a reference to that. Superposition, yeah. Observing a quantum object, observing an image of a quantum object, these are the same. Gravity's too heavy here. Spin. Benny, read what Theo said. Hang on a minute. Alright. Hi, Theo. I looked at your inspector. You're having some brutal bandwidth drops. So that's, Theo, that's on my end, yeah? Should I call Verizon at some point, you think? Thank you, by the way, for, you know, looking into it. It was good for a while. Honestly, it was good for, like, probably like a year and a half, I was having minimal issues. Yeah, it's your end, bug Verizon. I haven't changed my router in like 7 years. So I wonder if I need a new router. Maybe I just need to reset my router? That might be it. Shit. Alright, well thank you, Theo, I appreciate that. Holy fuck, get a new router, Vinny. Okay, I will. I will. No, I mean, I've unplugged it. But I haven't changed it. Not gonna lie, I have no idea who you are. I'm just here for Outer Wilds. It's all right. I'd prefer it that way. Honestly, that's for the best. Vinny Reed? I have read. It says here, observing an image of a quantum object. These are the same. Oh, hang on a minute. Hang on a minute. I think I understand now. God, and right at the end here now, too? Fuck. Oh boy. The arch and the crystal do not naturally meet. I'm not gonna have enough time to solve this stuff, will I? Crystal do not naturally meet. Oh, fuck. This is the last one, but we made it harder. Oh, no. Ah, fuck. I couldn't play the Song of Time, it wouldn't let me use the ocarina chat. I tried. Estoy looping. Yeah, there's the probe. See, now I know what the fuck I'm looking at. That's Giant's Deep, there's the broken probe, and there's the thing that was launched. What is that thing? I just saw another thing, you see that thing? Weird. Going to it. What are you going to, that blue dot? Shot it. Very nice. Very good. Also, chat was saying that it's pointless. Pilot just happened there. You don't always have to keep accelerating towards something. Oh, that's a good point. Yeah. Well, if anything, we can try to do that again at some point. The blue thing. Yep. I knew that was gonna happen. That was a fun thing to do. I just wanted to show the chat that you can in fact go in there. Isn't that cool? Alright, then there was that other thing. What was that other thing? I should go back to Giant's Deep before I, start futzing about with all this shit. Go to the moon and do the other things. I should. You were just a band. Just a band. A little band. Just four guys in the sky. It's like I keep getting distracted by other things when I should just stick to one. Well, not really should, but I kind of want to stick to one thing, but then there's all this cool stuff. My species didn't really colonize all of this planet, did they? Reverse waterfall. Mining site 2B. A geyser. It's a geyser? Nope, that's just a reverse waterfall. Yeah, they have one of those at Yellowstone. Interesting. I'm still amazed at how much ore the Ash Twin project requires, excuse me. Isn't this the ore for the remaining towers being built on Ash Twin? The completed towers I've seen are quite large. I was wondering about those towers. No, the material for those towers is all being taken from Ash Twin. The ore we're mining here will be used to craft an immensely thick protective shell that will physically seal off the chamber inside Ash Twin's core. If they're sealing off all entrances, I hope they've planned accordingly. That only works if they spoke English. I thought you had forbidden your apprentice from making puns, Coleus. How else would he improve? I'm relieved by our clan's decision to use Timber Hearth's ore only for constructing the shell. If eventually life on this planet were to evolve to the point of advanced metallurgy, I'm confident we won't have destroyed their ability to create. Well, that's nice of them. Projection stone. Yo, this room is... What is this psychedelic crazy room? This is a freak-out room. That's what they called them in the 60s. You'd go to, like, a concert, and they would call it, like, a freak-out. And it would just be, like, a bunch of loud, weird noises and music and, like, strange psychedelic visuals. And it would, like, they would heat up oil on a projector, and it would project, like, strange patterns. And, they call it a freak-out. Vinny, read the tablet. I don't know how to read the tablet. Oh. My gratitude for the latest shipment. Ono, Oneo. Oh, I know. This ore should be the last we'll need for the Ash Twin project. This is exciting news. Can I offer an extra set of eyes for this final check, specifically mine? If my work here is complete, I'd be delighted to help. We'd be grateful if you would. The more eyes, the better, as the smallest flaw or opening in the shell that protects the Ash Twin project could lead to disaster. Once we finish the shell that seals off the central chamber, we'll check to ensure that there are no longer any physical entrances. Rami and I will be checking the interior, and then checking the exterior for cracks, our final safety check.
Doodly-doo. You know, we were just having a little jambly-wambly. You know, marmalade jam. You know, on this Saturday evening. At EMI.
I don't know why this is happening. Because of the Paul Moon, I suppose. I blame the Paul Moon in chat, and now I'm doing nothing but Paul noises.
Ooh.
He doesn't even sound like that. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. That's not even, like, close to what he sounds like.
You know, Ringo, I think we should let them have the music for YouTube, you know what I mean? Let them play the songs.
No, Paul, we can't do that. It's a slippery slope. We let someone play a Beatles song, and soon enough, they're all playing Beatles songs.
Well, wait a minute, Ring. What's wrong with that?
Can't let them do that, Paul.
You feeling okay, Ring?
And he becomes, HAL 9000 from 2001.
I'm sorry, Paul, but our benefactors are paying me greatly to make sure that this music doesn't see the light of day. You know, I really wanted to play a Prince song on his birthday. Because I actually do like Prince music quite a bit. I think he's fucking amazing, and you wouldn't believe how good of a guitarist he is. There was a tribute to George Harrison they did While My Guitar Gently Weeps. And Prince did the guitar solos, the Eric Clapton stuff. And he was unbelievable. I probably talked about it on stream, and then he throws the guitar up into the air, and it doesn't come back down. But, yeah, no, he's amazing, but his estate, or his management, or whatever's going on there, they will fucking take you down in a second if you play his music. Like, I play a lot of different types of... What is that? I play a lot of different types of music, and sometimes I get lucky, and I feel like, alright, well, you know, someone is gonna get pissed. David Gilmour is gonna get pissed that I played this song, but the truth is, Prince, I'm genuinely afraid of. I just got an achievement for this. Is this like just a little probe that... I thought this was like a satellite. That, was there, you know, orbiting the planet. Maybe I should follow it. It is a satellite? Yeah, but look at it, it's leaving now. It's the moon guy's satellite? Oh, right, he was talking about that. That's right, that's right. You can push it, yeet it into the sun. Yeah, but then he wouldn't be able to spy with his four eyes. If I can land there. Coming in too fast. Easy feat. Yeah, I knew Captain Falcon was going to show up after I said that. Wrong chat. That was my Captain Falcon impression. Yo. Gotta
match velocity more often. It's a useful tool. There we go. Now that's a landing. Another happy landing. It was like the time we were in that Gundark nest.
Master, what is a Gundark?
I don't know. Han Solo said it in Empire Strikes Back, so... a reference for the fans.
Master, I'm hungry!
Feed yourself, Anakin, please. Mallow, my better 50% cassava is sending the last of the cannon components. Soon, relatively speaking, we'll know the eye's precise location. Thought of concluding our elder's curious and challenging search increases my heart's temperature, my love. Cassava tells me he and the construction yard crew have determined a power setting we are not, under any circumstances, to go above. I see, and am I right to think that consequently, we'll be ignoring that setting? At great peril. I can posit with nearly 100% certainty our friends have accounted for our natures, so I suggest we do. Given the orbital probe cannon, all the power it can structurally withstand creates the greatest chance of finding the eye in the universe. Yes, the probe must travel as fast as it can, and as far as it can, I'll make some adjustments. Yeah. The hell is this place? Is it here? Is it the ceiling? It's the cannon? Up to you to decipher it. Well, yeah. Yeah, I'm just asking rhetorical questions, don't mind me. I have bad news, Avens. Yarrow says there's a problem with the proposed power source, so the orbital probe cannon won't be asked to fire. I hope you're pulling my locomotive limb here, Cassava. Wait a minute. Wish I were, my friend, but no. They aren't certain they can fix the problem, so the orbital probe cannon is on an indefinite hiatus. Didn't we read this? But, well, I wasn't here, though. You read this on the planet. But this wasn't on Giant's Deep. Same clues, different place. There are some dupes to ensure you get all the informations. Oh, this is where we read it. Okay, all right. So. Someone tried to tell me words, Vinny, but they spelled words as wads. W-O-D-S, which is exactly what I've been saying for the past couple minutes. Exactly. damage report. Severe structural stress detected. Assessing damage. Intact. No structural damage. Viewport window fractured.
Viewport window fractured.
Module exposed to vacuum of space. Probe tracking module missing. I think I slept too much today because I'm in a really fucking weird mood, really wacky. Like, I was like half delirious today. Well, this... I can just go through, I don't know what to do here now. That before? What about this? This thing. Can I get the ball here? Yes. That looks like Brittle Hollow. Strange. Why did the lore go away? Cannon aligned with randomly selected probe trajectory, gravity field activated. 17 minutes 29 seconds ago, request to launch probe received from Ash Twin Project. But how? Where did the signal come from? No one's alive down there. Or are they? Ash Twin Project. We gotta go to the Ash Twin and find out what the fuck happened here. Vinny, next there's more tubes? I missed the tubes? Oh yeah, there are more tubes. Shit. Alright, let's get the rest of the tubes. Huh. Okay. That's how it broke apart. So, begin launch log, orbital probe cannons, launch request received, probe launch successful. Probe tracking module is receiving data from probe. And a warning, orbital probe cannon structure compromised during launch, damage to multiple modules detected. Oh, and then there's this, which we already saw. I understand now. It was like a little visual representation. Someone said, why don't we have lore like this on Earth? Because we have clickbait instead. A Someone said read a history book. His... Whose story? His? We don't have a lot of time left in this loop. And instead of going to the Tower of Quantum Fuckcanics, I'm gonna head over to, the Ash Twin. Yeah, we're gonna go to the Sun. If you can walk on the sun. Booyakasha, welcome to my main man, Buzz Aldrin, the first geezer to walk on the sun. You can't walk on the sun, it's too hot, but surely you can walk on the sun in the winter. That's Ally G. No one's seen Ally G? He actually went and asked Buzz Aldrin what it was like to walk on the sun. And then when Buzz Aldrin said, you can't walk on the sun, he was like, you can walk on the sun in the winter. So, yeah, I didn't just make that up. That's... Imagine having gone to the moon, allegedly, and having some dude then tell you that you can walk on the sun with a straight face and be, like, totally convincing about how stupid he is. Yeah, I didn't say allegedly, did I? Not a lot was done there. I mean, we got a lot of informations, but I didn't do anything on the Ash Twin. Vinny believes the moon landings were faked. I actually don't. I've talked about it plenty of times. I think we've actually been to the moon. That's the controversial statement, though. I think, if anything, it's possible that some of the footage was faked for the first Apollo mission because they lost some of it. I actually do believe that, because some of that footage is a little weird. It's a long story, but I think that's probably what throws people off. However, if you told me that we were lied to about the moon landings, I would process that for about 5 minutes, and I'd be like, wait a minute, we were lied to by the government? Alright. Sure. Though I do believe we've been there. Someone said, I don't care either way, to be honest. Well, I mean, when JFK said we would go to the moon and do the other things, I thought for sure that we would actually do the other things. But we didn't, did we? We're getting there. I mean, we got a Mars mission planned. Going to Mars, I guess. Vinny, we have reflectors on the moon, which measure stuff all the time. Again, we have been to the moon. I think if there's any doubt about one mission, it's the first Apollo mission. About some of the footage. That's my only real... That's my only real doubt at this point. I'm just like... The more you learn about conspiracy theories, the more it makes me sick to my stomach, so I just kind of stop. Someone said, Jesus Christ, Vinny, come on. Explain, what do you mean, Jesus Christ, come on? Too, rational for you? Also, I guess we died. Yeah, so it turns out that the sun has a lot of gravity. You know, the same thing that keeps the planets in orbit. And I'm not even going to attempt to land on Sun Station. Can you fuck with your computer's wires? They're glowing. What? Loop wasted. Alright, maybe the quantum trials could be finished? I'm trying to think of, like, what would be the best thing, because the Ash Twin, I can't seem to get to that. At least, there's not much to do on it until the very end. Could be wrong on that one. So, we'll do the quantum trials again. We're so fucking close to finishing that, too. Riddle Hollow. Wait, what's this planet? Oh, Dark Bramble. Oh, so I was confusing the Riddle Hollow with the Dark Bramble a bunch. Then there's the Interloper, which I wouldn't mind landing on. I wonder if the Hollow Lantern could be landed on. Interloper. Yeah, we'll get to the Bramble. I just, again, kind of like Breath of the Wild. You set a goal, and then a million things distract you. Yeah, I don't have a very good feeling about this interloper. I don't like it. I think it's probably... Even just by the name alone, probably causing a lot of problems here in this solar system. to get to the bottom of this thing. Lavos, maybe. Good. Could have been way worse. Discovery. Some kind of thing here. This is troublesome. It seems the comet wishes to submerge our shuttle in ice. If we stay on the surface too long, the shuttle may freeze entirely. Even if it did, couldn't someone call it back home to the gravity cannon on Ember Twin? What's that noise? Yes, but the exploration of the comet would be more difficult if we were without the shuttle until someone recalled it. Perhaps we should have landed on the dark side of the comet. Suppose one of us remain in the shuttle to keep it warm and continued monitoring the surface. This would be wise, I think, Clary. If you don't mind waiting here with it, Pokey and I can continue investigating the surface. It's just like totally frozen in ice. Wonder if there's a way in there. Uh-oh. Jesus. Wow, this thing goes fast. So my ship is gone. It looks like there ain't no getting off of this ship we're on. Oh wait, no, I said that wrong. No, this is a comet. Vinny, you can catch it if you leave now. I'm not even going to make the attempt, my friend. I just want to know what else there is to do on here while I'm here. I don't want to squander the opportunity. Ship. Right. I need to find a way to get into the ship, then. Vinny, you don't have enough oxygen. Cool. Well, at least we can ice skate. I wonder if it gets any closer to the sun. This loop. Or if we're already, like, out way too far. What the hell is this? Strange. Black hole over here. Is it the quantum station? Is it the white moon? The white thing? Whatever it was? There it is. The white hole. 3 minutes of oxygen remaining. Fuel level critical. It's fine. It's fine. Ooh. Jesus. Here we go. Marv! Marvis! Marv. Oh my God. We can't get in. Can't enter a white hole. Oh well. I was about to play some music, but then I got a cool ad and it ruined it. I haven't seen Interstellar more than the one time I saw it in the theater. I'm probably gonna have to change that soon. Because I just want to hear the soundtrack again.
They're going as tires, we're gonna find tires.
What is that? You need a tire? Aren't you going to space? Like in a spaceship?
I just have tires. So.
Interstellar soundtrack would be dope during the stream. Yeah, it would also probably shut down the stream. Sadly.
DMCA2.
Try this again. If you could go to a planet, which planet would you visit? Does that include all of fiction? Someone wants to know my answer. Everyone in chat is saying Uranus. in our solar system, I would like to be on Pluto. I'm going to count it as a planet just to see what the solar system looks like from that far out. Or maybe Nibiru. You know, the secret planet? The quantum planet? I just want to... Yeah, I want to see what it's like. I mean, it would probably be, like, really shitty. So maybe that one kind of sucks. If it was a fictional planet, the one that Thanos retires to, after he's put in his 40 years and he's got his pension. Even though that's just like a nice, like temperate Earth-like planet. Other planets. Ryza from Star Trek. Ryzen. Also, say what you want about the prequels, but Naboo looks like a pretty cool place to live. Do you remember the space gondola? I remember that space gondola. We are gonna go to the planet Kor. And then he never actually leaves his palace. Coruscant might be cool. Yeah, Coruscant would be actually really cool. The probe was getting, like, a minor glimpse, I feel, of the gate. So I think I need to launch a better probe. You only need to take the one picture? Oh, okay. Vinny, what are you doing? I'm waiting for this gate to appear over here. The gate doesn't move? Yeah, it does. Doesn't... it did. Okay, well now that happened, so that's fine. Oh, cool crystal. Cool crystal. Cool fucking... Oh, now the gate's gone. Because the picture's gone. Oh my god.
We need to spin!
Why would the game do this to me? Because someone in chat wrote, because you're are stupid. I love it when someone tries to burn the streamer and then they misspell their burn. Oh yeah, no, that's okay. The knee is exploded for now, but when my character dies and comes back, it'll be just fine. Annoying. I mean, it's generous with the pictures, at least, even if it doesn't make 100% sense. No, I mean, it makes sense, but if you take a picture and are not constantly monitoring it, that's an old picture. It's not still being monitored. You need a video feed on it. I'm a quantum physicist. I know what I'm talking about. Not how that works. Even things you see are old. The picture and the thing are linked. No, I mean like, not in the game chat. Are we talking about real life or game life? Who's quantum physics? Raise your hand. We offer our congratulations. You've learned the rule of quantum imaging. Take this knowledge with you on the remainder of your quantum pilgrimage. Remember, the other quantum shards have other lessons to teach. Our curiosity goes with you on your journey. You walk in the footsteps of those who came before you, and your path guides those who follow later. That's right, I'm a quantum paisano. Well, I did the thing. Frozen on my shuttle. Gravity cannon. There's more to explore here. Alright. Someone in the chat said Quantum Tarantino. Yeah, I love Quantum Tarantino's films. But the cool thing about Quantum Tarantino is that he's always looking at feet, unless you're observing him, and then he's looking at the other foot. I'm gonna head back to the Ash Twin. Also, the Interloper, I think when it's close to the sun, maybe the ice will melt, and then I can get in that ship. His films are only bad if you watch them. Oh no! I got lazy. I was busy looking at chat. I was like, oh, that's fine. The autopilot will get me where I need to go. That's probably, what, the fifth time? Someone said autopilot killed me about 20 times, and surprisingly only one or two of them were the sun. Well, you're paying more attention than I am then, because I am just getting fucking destroyed by the sun. The Interloper again. This time I'm gonna let it get close to the sun. My destination's Dark Bramble definitely has to happen. And the other thing I would like to do is... What's that? Is that the thing again? The white thing? You know, the white hole? The Ash Twin. I wanna find out what's going on over there. Please, autopilot, do not get me killed. Okay, I see why now. That person was like, autopilot got me killed. I get it. I understand it now. This time, we're gonna make it a little harder for the ship to be, yeeted. Another happy landing. We're getting kind of close to the sun. Maybe this will do what it has to do. Don't know. Kenobi is Wedge's nephew. Well, that's an interesting way to say it. I know exactly what you mean, but the way you worded that was very interesting. Oh. Dennis Lawson is Ewan McGregor's uncle, the actor who played Wedge. Did it. Oh, ghost matter. Oh, fuck you! It warned you and you rushed in. Yep, I did. Well, it looked like there was only a little bit. Can't let that go. I have to go back there. We'll try to avoid the sun this time. Someone just wrote, "Sun, sun, sun, here it comes." Here comes the sun, doo-doo-doo-doo. George Harrison was on some kind of fucking LSD trip in his garden with Eric Clapton, Electric Clapton. And he was like, projecting his mind into the future gamers of today, watching this game and watching the shuttle go into the sun. Eric, I've seen something amazing. What'd you see, George?
I've seen the sun. There's a ship, it goes into the sun. I've seen a crusty gamer. A crusty gamer was playing a game.
Oh, then he crashed into a comet. You're right there, George.
Crusty gamers, Eric. Crusty gamers.
What did he look like, George?
He had a crusty sock on his desk, Eric. So I wrote a song called Here Comes the Sun.
I'm sure this bit can be further developed, but it's very crusty. There's not much to it. I haven't thought about it very, very much. Vinny, your lucky staff left. I think. Yeah. Yeah, that's a good point. Vin, you need new writers. Yeah, chat hasn't been giving me good material lately. Bye, ship. Receiving much stronger energy readings now that we're beneath the crust. Whatever it is must lie somewhere below, closer to the comet's center. Starting to think it's more dangerous than we realized. Clary, can you hear us? Yes, but your voices are faint. I fear we will lose communication entirely if you continue any deeper. Keep the shuttle warm for us, Clary. We'll return the moment we identify the source of the energy readings. I understand, but be cautious, both of you. Vinny, forgot Drake's birthday? I did. I didn't even breathe for that. Alien spacesuit. Killed by the ghost crystals. The interloper. Thank you. Good choice of music. Or music style. The spherical stone casing here seems to be the source of the energy readings. No, rather the source of what's within the stone. I'm detecting some form of exotic matter. Stone is muting our energy readings. They should be 10 times what we're seeing, at least. Pi, I don't think we want this matter interacting with us. As far as I can tell, direct contact with it would almost certainly be fatal. I've never encountered anything like this casing. But it's all that's protecting us from what's inside. Worse still, this matter is disturbingly volatile. Pi, whatever the matter inside the stone casing is, it's more than just profoundly unstable. It's under tons of pressure. Look at this density scan. I've never seen anything this tightly compacted before. What is it? This is orders of magnitude worse than I'd imagined. If this stone were to rupture, the lethal matter within would rapidly expand, completely blanketing the star system almost instantly. And the pressure is still building as the comet approaches the star system. Return to the shuttle right now. The rest of our friends need to know they're in terrible danger. Leave your equipment and run. What are you doing, Pi? The more we know about this alien matter, the better our chances of survival. I'll learn what I can here. Go, warn the others. Maybe they can construct shelter somehow. Now. Now, Pokey! Who's Pokey? Pokemon? One second, chat. What do I do now? Alright, this is a little... This is a little scary. Make sure there's nothing else. There's other, like, paths and tubes, but... They're full of... bad stuff. This is how Tiberium got to Earth, yeah. There's a thing here. No. The stone you're looking at is already burst open. Well, did that I know. Yeah, obviously this isn't spherical anymore, so... Burst and nursed. I don't know what to do now. Do I just die in here? Look around? I did. Hang on a second. I'm wondering. You're in a frozen comet, you must die anyway. That's a good point. Hang on a minute.
I've seen things you people wouldn't believe. Attack ships on fire off the shoulder of Orion. I watched sea beams glitter in the dark near the 10 hours a game. All those moments will be lost in time. Like tears.
I wonder if that'll get claimed. The volume was pretty low. There were other sounds happening. Guess we'll see. I kind of wish that the, game didn't... wish the game didn't, like, stop. Didn't, like, freeze. When I alt-tabbed out. Well, I think that's gonna be it for today. Let's take a look at the ship log. It'll be claimed by someone who did a bad cover of Vangelis. Yeah, probably. Sorry, Vangelis. Yeah, we have to do some barn finders. You know what? Nah, one more loop. Fuck it. Barn finders is not that important. we can wait. That game can wait. A lot of stuff here. You just broke the devs' hearts. They'll be all right. Bramble time it is.
Lord, I was born a bramblin' man, trying to make a living and doing the best I can.
I watched a little video someone linked me about why SpongeBob is a unique show and there will never be another show like SpongeBob, talking about Squidward. And specifically Squidward's outlook versus SpongeBob's outlook. And, this is interesting. I understand a little bit better why people like SpongeBob, the first three seasons in particular. Because I played Rehydrated yesterday, and people were like, Vinny, why don't you know SpongeBob? I'm like, I just don't. But now I kind of understand a little bit better. It's kind of spooky in here, chat. As in, very spooky. Okay, my friend.
Hmm.
Oh my god. I nearly shit myself. Holy fuck. Okay, well that brought back some bad Subnautica memories. I mean, good, but also bad. Please don't do this. Oh, please don't do this! Please don't do this! I really should have my guitar ready for just such an occasion. Let me see if I can... Let's see if I can get this. I actually don't know what key the song is in. I think it's D, but I don't know. I think it might be a capo.
DMCA, little darling, DMCA, it's alright, here it comes. It's time for claim, little bignot, you know, play song.
Like that. Yeah, I'll figure it out. I'm surprised I never actually learned how to play that song. It feels like one of those things that you have to learn in order to learn how to play guitar. You should learn Here Comes the Sun. And yet I was always more of a Norwegian wood guy. Something like that. Now, listen, if me playing that on an unplugged electric guitar and screwing it up twice gets claimed, and somehow Paul McCartney and Ringo get the rest of the money from the video, I'm just gonna stop. You know what? I'm gonna burn Beatle records. That's what I'm gonna do, just like they did in the 60s. I'm gonna burn them. Okay, alright. Chat, this is... This is very scary. Okay, and I don't like this. The inside of this planet looks so much bigger.
off!
I mean, I saw it from the scout, kind of. I'll try one more. God, I hate that so much. Use your signal scope. I guess. There were a ton on the scout. Yeah, that was where I was going, though. I was trying to get to that area so I could... Wait, maybe that was a bad idea. There's no way autopilot's gonna kill me here. What to do? Avoid... I'm just gonna try to avoid the lights, I guess. That's the best... It's the best I've got. Wait. There's someone in here playing harmonica. Or was that beyond this planet? I think that was beyond. No, that was just a... Never mind. There's the core. We just overshot it. Maybe the harmonica is here somewhere, I don't know. Chat, I'm doing a thing. And then there's more. What the fuck is that? What is that? Duplicate signal. It's in two places at the same time, chat. There's that thing. Try to get in there. Close. Pfft. Keeps going. Huh? Did I just get back to the entrance? So I'm so confused. This is insanity. This whole section of the game is just pure craziness, chat. Pure craziness. Look at the scout. If I was playing this in VR, oh, I would have... There would have been poop. Yes, sirree, Jim. That's bullshit. It was already there. I just warped into the mouth of an anglerfish. More time. Last time, and then barn finders. Please, chat, avoid spoils. Seriously, I'll just, you know, let me discover this stuff on my own. Yeah, that's after I'm done with this shit. That's my next project. I have to learn Here Comes the Sun. Yeah, this planet, though, makes me upset. I don't like this planet, if you can even call it a planet. This is a very upsetting planet. Please. Please. No, wrong button. Found it. Found something. I guess there really was someone here. This reminds me of a part of Skies of Arcadia that I really like. Let's see if I can actually even fucking land in here. You can't park the ship here. Go around. Ah, shit. Well, I forgot to put my suit on. Oh my God. Oh. My God. How could it not have happened that way? Like, as I was exiting the ship, I saw my hands. My alien hands, and I was like, oh no. Barn finders blown the fuck out. I need to know what's there too. I'm not even planning on doing a full loop. I just need to know what's there. Is this David Attenborough? So you know, really, what the fuck is that thing? Is that the quantum moon? I mean, we'll still get, like, 50 minutes of Bard Finders. I really need to know, like, what's in there and who's in there. That's important. Vinny, the strumming sounded awful angry. Oh, well, I'm really angry more at myself than anything else, yeah. No, that's definitely... Oh, you are a dupe. Well then. Yeah, we're good. No, we're good here, chat. Everything here's fine. Everything here is fine. It's scarier without the ship, isn't it? And a very limited fuel supply. I'm gonna guess that there's an anglerfish right in front of the spot I need to go. Fuel. Fuck is this thing? Was that a Jape signal? It went through the heart of the fucking planet. It was Jape. Almost out of fuel. But that's okay. This is also an anglerfish. Just it looks like a dead one. Wow. I did it, I'm here. Feldspar. Whoa! Where'd you come from? No one's come in here. Well, ever, actually. That makes you the second Harthian to ever reach the Dark Bramble. After me, of course. Well done. I'd say it's you. I made you an astronaut? You haven't blown yourself up yet? Good for you. Feldspar, you're alive! You never were the brightest hatchling, were you? That's right, I'm alive. I've been camping out here since my ship, crashed violently. Wait, what? Oh, this is a good story. I had just finished up exploring the core of Giant's Deep and needed a new challenge, and none of us had ever been inside the Dark Bramble, so I think, hey, let's give that a try. So I've been cruising around for a while, dodging the odd massive interdimensional vine bristling with thorns, and I run into a huge anglerfish, the biggest I'd ever seen. Pull a few stunts, try to shake the thing off. Nothing too fancy. I'm going full speed when the fish clips me, knocks me into a vine, and... well, like I said, I crash. Blammo! On impact, my ship starts making noises like it's coming apart from the inside, and I think, well, that ain't great. Sure enough, I barely get out of there before the electrical system starts sparking like crazy. It's either move fast or die unpleasantly. So I had to put a little distance between me and my poor fried ship. I camped out near where I crashed at first. I found the skeleton later. Great find. Would have been stupid not to use it. So I moved my setup over here and planted my emergency tree seeds. Been here ever since. Can't believe you didn't die. You know, in the old days, I used to think the same thing every time I came back from a flight in one piece. These days, I'm used to it. Anyway, that's how it all went down, hatchling. Story's over, but feel free to stay and enjoy the fire for a while. Or don't. Fire's not going anywhere. I found something. I found a Dark Bramble seed on Timber Hearth. That's bad business, hatchling. As Chert will tell you, if you so much as glance in the Dark Bramble's direction, there used to be a fifth planet where the Bramble is now. This infernal plant appeared at the center and kept growing and growing and growing until it shattered the planet and scattered its pieces across space. If we don't get that seed you found sorted real quick, like, I suspect Timber Hearth will be headed toward the same fate. I'll tell you what, we Harthians have overcome far too much to be done in by some worthless seed. Man, there's a lot of threats in this solar system. Where should I explore? That's the spirit. Anywhere's good, but you should know that space is weird in here, intensely. Ever tried throwing your probe into one of these weird seeds? See there? With that little opening? Just big enough to launch one through. Your probe tracker will tell you the probe is in two places at once, but I don't think that's wrong exactly. Because space doesn't work right in here. The seed looks small, but see? Inside it's bigger. Much bigger. I've had a lot of time to think about this, but my theory in space is, space in Dark Bramble kind of expands as you go through each sphere. That's why it's bigger inside those seeds. That's my theory. Keep that in mind while you're exploring Dark Bramble, and maybe you won't get lost inside forever. Good luck! You reached the core. How'd you do it? Giant's Deep Core. That was a wild one. Since you're asking, I gotta assume you hadn't made it down there yourself yet, right? If I tell you how, it kind of feels like cheating. On a completely unrelated note, that sure was big hollow vine my ship crashed into. If I were you, I'd go take a walk and see where it ends. You'll want to go to the tail end of this anglerfish skeleton here, look for a flickering light in the fog. That'll be my old ship. Where's your ship? Not far from here. Right? We know that. Okay. What happened to this anglerfish? Oh, the skeleton? It was like this when I got here. As near as I can tell, this anglerfish must have been chewing on the vine and eaten a seed, and then the seed grew and grew in the poor fish's stomach until this happened. Gross, huh? Skeleton was a good find. The light keeps the fish away, you know. See, they're territorial, so they mostly avoid each other. That's why I set up camp here. Shouldn't I tell ground control to come get you? Well, yeah, sure, whenever you have the time. Frankly, I kind of like it out here. Quiet, peaceful-ish. And a little young to understand, or you're a little young to understand, but it's a lot of pressure being the best that ever was. Been nice to have a break. Imagine all that, and then I just, like, die from the fire. Oh, cool centipede. Ew. So, how are you eating? He's got emergency trees. Oh, he's eating the trees. Well, that makes more sense. I mean, you know, was gonna end here. Was gonna end just meeting the dude, but I guess we're going through here. My god, it's full of stars. That just warps us back around. And we're out. We made it out. I guess I'll have to come back here at some point. Seems like there's some unfinished business. Error duplicate signal. Wait, is that on Timber Hearth? Vinny, I can't believe you missed it. You missed the shortcut. Vinny, go to your ship. What ship? Feldspar meant for you to stay inside the vine. Yeah, there's no ship left, chat. I don't know what you're talking about. I have to die to reset this loop. I'll come back to it. you went the wrong way. Probably. I'm also trying to, you know, I just wanted to get to that dude. Now I know how to get to him. Yeah, use oxygen as a propellant. Yeah. Okay, we'll stop here. Very, very good game. I'm really into it. But we definitely... I need to plan ahead a little bit better, because it was way too easy to get stuck playing this. Even a little bit of Barn Finders is fine. It doesn't need a tremendously long stream. So I'm excited to just play a little bit. Stick around. I'll be back. Tonal Whiplash up next.